पीसीओडी इज अ हार्मोनल डिसऑर्डर. इट नॉट ओनली डिस्टर्ब्स योर मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल बट ऑल्सो इंड्यूसेस अदर हार्मोनल प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक वेट गेन, फेशियल हेयर, इंसुलिन रेजिस्टेंस एंड फर्टिलिटी इश्यूज. Many factors lead to PCOD, like if you have a poor lifestyle, if there is genetic disposition, if you have stress, environmental effects. It's a metabolic condition and it can be controlled through a good diet. So in this video, I'm going to share with you some ideas for a day of an ideal PCOD diet, and I'm sure it would be very helpful for you to follow and reduce your PCOD trouble. So can PCOD be cured by diet? We can't say that healthy diet can cure PCOD, but it can positively manage the symptoms and cope other health problems associated with it. Along with a good exercise routine and good diet, it may reverse the condition to some extent. So which food is good for PCOD? Consumption of whole grains, legumes, unprocessed food, leafy greens like spinach, broccoli, red color foods like cherries, grapes, and pomegranates. Healthy fats like ghee, avocado, olive oil, these are good for PCOS. It's also important to cut down refined grains, sugary foods, unhealthy fats like saturated fats. PCOD diet is not one size fits all diet. It's customized to focus on nourishing the body and regulating the functioning of the hormone. So here in this video, I'll share with you a full day meal plan that can give you a fair idea of what foods you can incorporate in your diet if you have PCOD problem. So start your day with a glass full of water wherein you soak fenugreek seeds overnight. So these seeds regulate blood sugar level, and the soluble fiber content of the fenugreek seeds promotes slow absorption of sugar. If we talk about breakfast, suppose if you are having a quarter plate of poha with vegetable, add a protein rich bowl of green moong sprouts. Both meals are loaded with vitamins and minerals, which will give you adequate supply of vitamins for the day. You can also pair this meal with a glass of buttermilk for, you can say, high biological value protein. Also, you can add some cubes of paneer if you don't like buttermilk. Now, for your mid-meal snack, which is around 10 or 11 o'clock between breakfast and lunch, because you don't want a very long gap between meals, especially when you are at work. Because when you keep long gap, you tend to eat more in your main meals. Like after breakfast, if you just eat lunch, so you tend to eat a heavy lunch. So try to have a healthy mid-morning snack like fruits, trail mix, or you can also have any roasted chana or makhana or roasted peanuts, as these also have low glycemic index. So in PCOD or PCOS, there is insulin resistance, so we don't want blood sugar spike. So incorporating the low GI food is very helpful for a girl with PCOD. Okay, so for lunch, you can go with a bowl of rice with a bowl of plain dal with some seasonal vegetables which are high in soluble fiber, like lauki. You can have tori, you can have leafy greens, you can have beans, you can have broccoli. So these are high fiber and quite nutrient rich vegetables. You can also go for multigrain chapatis with any soya or paneer preparation, because these are also high in protein. But always make sure that you are eating some salad. For good vitamin C, you can add lemon juice to your salad. Now, if we talk about evening session, so in evening we usually feel like eating something savory and something, you know, most of the time we end up eating junk. So you can have your cup of tea if you like, but if you can still manage to avoid it, you can have coconut water instead. You can have a big bowl of watermelon, and try to make a homemade bhel puri. Like you can have some puffed rice, you can include some boiled chana or some sprouts, you can add some chopped onions and some chopped tomatoes, and you can add some lemon juice to this preparation. So it's a healthy snack. And if you don't have sprouts, you can use even bhuna chana. So coming to dinner, Dinner is a good idea to go light, and some days you can have a carb-free dinner, so you can have a high protein and high fiber. So what you can do is saute some vegetables like maybe carrots, capsicum, beans, all these kinds of vegetables, and with that you can have 100 grams of paneer and tofu cubes. So on few days you can have this. If you're a non-vegetarian, you can have 100 to 150 grams of chicken, and with that you can have some seasonal sorted vegetables. You can have a chicken soup, mixed vegetable soup. So it's not necessary that you should have this kind of dinner every day. On few days you can club some carbohydrates like chapatis and rice. Definitely, that's not an issue. So in PCOD, usually the doctors advise to avoid the dairy products, because these days we know that there is issues with antibiotics given to cattle. And yes, there might be some problem, but I would suggest go for a low fat and a nice brand of dairy. Go for low fat milk. And if still you want to avoid dairy, so at least include sesame seeds and ragi, which is also known as finger millet, because these are high in calcium. So if you are cutting down on milk, I don't want you to cut down on your daily calcium requirements. So this is one thing that you should take into consideration. So this is just a general plan that I have shared. Of course, the quantities, the portion size definitely differ if we talk about individual day's requirement of carbohydrate, protein, fats and calories. So in case if you want to get in touch with me for your well-calculated plan as per your requirement, you can DM me on Instagram and you can check the link in the description below. And thank you so much again for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel, make sure that you subscribe. My name is Tanya and I'm a nutritionist. Eat healthy and stay healthy with Health Fit Nutrition.